Hello friends, today we will study what is meant by large integer multiplication. Multiplication signifies multiplying any two numbers, that is finding the product of any two entities. When I multiply 1 into 2, I get 2, 2 into 3 is 6. But why do we have to study the large integer multiplication? You will see, or as we have always observed, as my numbers or integers increase in size, my multiplication becomes tougher. And for the programming strategy, if I have a multiplication which happens more number of times, then the time complexity of my particular program or function always increases. So here we will look how the large integer multiplication can be reduced on the time complexity front. Now, multiplication using a brute force technique is the first thing that we are going to see. What is a brute force technique? That is, I get a simple number, multiplication of my regular integers in my regular manner without applying any algorithmic approach. So, A and B both are n-digit integers. If we use the brute force approach to compute, C is equal to A into B. What is the time efficiency? Here, A is single whole integer, B is another integer. I am multiplying A into B. There is only one multiplication that happens over here. So what is the time efficiency or time complexity for this? If A is equal to 12 and B is equal to 10, then C is equal to A into B, which is 120. The time complexity is theta n square. So here the time complexity raises, if you see, by the power of 2 for the simple brute force approach. Now here, if I have more bigger, then to the power of 2 with the size of my integer, it is going to lapse to many fold if the size of my integer, if the size of my integer is very large. So what I do when I'm multiplying large integers, for example, I have taken the number A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and B is equal to 1, 1, 7, 9, 33. This is just a simple number which has been taken. So what do I do next? I say we split this number into two equal parts when I'm using a divide and conquer approach. As divide and conquer always works on splitting the whole world real problem into small sub-problems. So here, when I'm applying the divide and conquer approach to large integers, I will automatically split it into two parts. When I split the numbers into two equal parts, what happens? It is said that my number A will be splitted into A1 and A0. And here, when I split my number, my A1 is equal to 1, 2, 3 and my A0 is equal to 4, 5, 6. Now, B is equal to B1 is equal to B0. If the two numbers were 7, 8, 6, 9, 3, 2, then I split it into 7, 8, 6 and 9, 3, 2. So, I have my B1 and B0. I have my A1 and A0. C is equal to A into B. That is what I need my final result to be. I need to find the product of A into B. That is my normal brute force approach. Now, using this divide and conquer, I have splitted my numbers into four sub problems. So what do I do? Here is a simple strategic approach. It says A1 into 10 raised to the power of n by 2 plus A0, B1 10 raised to the power of n by 2 plus B0. Here we are splitting the problems in the parts. here my n by 2, as there are 6 numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So when I say n by 2, so 6 by 2, 3. So a1, 10 raised to the power of 3 plus a0. Here a1 is 1, 2, 3. So my number will be 1, 2, 3, 10 raised to the power of 3 plus 4, 5, 6. Into b1 is 7, 8, 6. Again, it has 6 digits. So n by 2 is 10 raised to the power of 3 plus b0. So b1 is 7, 8, 6 into 10 raised to the power of 3 plus 9, 3, 2. This is with a single multiplication. We have a into b, how we have now split it. Now the simple formula will be, we start opening up the brackets and we start multiplying the digits. When we multiply the simple formula, what we get? We get a1 b1 10 raised to the power of n. What is 10 raised to the power of n? 10 raised to the power of 6. So a1 is 123, b1 is 786. So 123 into 786, 10 raised to the power of 6. A1 is again 123. So 123 into b0, which is 932, plus a0, which is 456, into b1, which is 786. 10 raised to the power of 3, plus a0, b0. a0 is 456 and b0 is 932. Here is a simple thing that we see how we'll be substituting those values. Here again we will be seeing what it happens. What I had said, 1, 2, 3, 10 raised to the power of 3 plus 456, 786 into 10 raised to the power of 3 plus 932. And we write it in this simpler manner. Now what happens when I write it in this simpler manner? You will observe, how many multiplication signs are there? So what happens is, the number of multiplication signs, once I ignore the 10 raised to the power variable from my equation, I have 4 multiplication symbols. That is 123 into 786, 123 into 932, 456 into 786, 456 into 932. It has been reduced to 4 multiplication signs and 3 addition signs. So the complexity is in the term of 4 multiplication and 3 additions. So what we do, how do we reduce this? A is equal to A1, A0, B is equal to B1, B0, that is what we have termed till now. A and B are n-digit numbers, again revising it, A1, A0, B1, B2, n by 2 are the digit numbers. C is equal to A into B. This is all we finally concluded to one single statement that would lead us with 4 multiplications and 3 additions. How many single digit multiplications are needed to compute A into B? If we ignore the shifting operations required for multiplying, that is 10 raised to n and 10 raised to n by 2, how many single digit multiplications are needed to compute A into B? If we ignore the shifting operations required for multiplying 10 raised to the power of n and 10 raised to the power of n by 2, or any further 10 raised to the powers of n, as we will be dividing the problem into subproblems. This was the equation that we've got. A1 into B1, 10 raised to the power of n, plus A1 into B0, plus A0 into B1, 10 raised to the power of n by 2, plus A0 into B0. So these are the 4 multiplication signs that will come into picture. So what we do, as we know, A is A1, A0, B is equal to B1, B0, C is equal to A into B. This is a repetitive, as we have to find out the multiplication of integers. So we have the same statement which comes into picture. So what do? We say that we signify A1 into B1 by a new variable called C2, and A1 into B0 plus A0 into B1 is signified by another new variable called C1, and A0 B0 by a variable called C0. So the whole equation is reduced to C2 10 raised to the power of n, C1 10 raised to the power of n by 2 plus C0. This is the new equation that we get. But what is the advantage of having this equation? Why do we need a new terms that come into picture for this large integer multiplication? Where we've seen C2 is the product of the first two halves, C1, C0 is the product of the second halves, and C1 is A1 plus A0 into B1 plus B0. And if we do minus C2 plus C0 is the product of the sum of the A's half and the sum of the B's half minus the sum of C2 and C0. Here the new term which has come into picture is C2 plus C0. What is the advantage of having C1 is equal to A1 plus A0 into B1 plus B0 minus C2 C0? If you will see, C2 and C0 is A1, B1, A0, B0. When we open up the bracket, the A1, B1 and A0, B0 are cancelled. So we are left out with only the term C2. And for this equation, that is C2 10 raised to the power of n and C1 10 raised to the power of n by 2 plus C0, where all these conditions we've seen, and when we say minus C2 plus C0, I showed you that A1 plus A0, B1 plus B0 minus C2 plus C0, when we do, we come down to a simple terminology of the center elements. Then how many single digit multiplications are existing over there? The single digit multiplications that are existing in this case, that is C2 10 raised to the power of n, C1 10 raised to the power of n by 2 plus C0. Here, the single digit multiplication will be n by 2 digits. That is, only 2 multiplications will be happening at that particular instance. As we've reduced down by cancelling, by adding C2 and C0. M of n, that is the matrix multiplication complexity, is equal to 3m n by 2 for n greater than 1. For m of 1, then it is equivalent to 1. If it is a single digit, then obviously the complexity is equal to 1. And when I keep on multiplying, the complexity, that is m of n, is approximately equal to n raised to the power of 1.585. I reduce down my multiplication factors to 2 when I cancel out C2 and C1. This is just an approach of divide and conquer to show how the multiplication of two large digit numbers or two large digit integers can be done, and using divide and conquer strategy, how it can be reduced. Thank you.